Good morning, everyone, everywhere, and welcome to worship with Homer United Methodist Church. If you are worshiping online today, welcome. Take a moment to say good morning in the comments and be sure you let us know if you've got any special prayer requests. And thank you for all of you in person continuing to follow our COVID safety protocols. I wanted to let you know that Savannah and I are working on a grant to get some portable air filtration systems for in here. The one problem with our beautiful sanctuary is none of the windows open. And our air handler is spotty sometimes. And so once we get those in place, we'll be able to go to masks optional so that you can be a little more comfortable and a little more cooler now that we're heading into the summer months. For thousands of years, this place where we prayerfully gather today has been under the care of the Dena'ina and the Sugpiaq peoples. Their presence in this region has protected these sacred lands and waters for millennia, and they're still stewarding this place today. We continually commit ourselves to partner with others in repairing past harm and moving forward with awareness and respect. I'd invite you to stand as you're able for our opening prayer. And Joe, I'd ask that you turn down the mic just a little bit. I don't need to be this shouty this morning. We know that Christ is our shepherd who welcomes and calls us. Our shepherd grants us abundant life, protects us from harm, and walks with us always. As our opening prayer today, let us recite together Psalm 23 as a reminder of Christ's abiding presence with us always. Let us pray. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. You may be seated.
Please bow with me for the prayer of illumination. Risen Savior, we rest secure in your flock. We are your sheep. Speak to us. We will hear our shepherd's voice. Amen. Our first reading is from Revelation chapter 7, verses 9 through 17. This is the New Revised Standard Version. I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white. With palm branches in their hands, they cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God, who is seated on the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen. Blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white? And where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat, for the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to the springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Please stand as you're able for the reading of the gospel. follow me. I give them eternal life, and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hand. What my Father has given me is greater than all else, and no one can snatch it out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God. You may be seated, and I'd like to invite the children to come forward and join me for a few minutes. Good morning. Today you have to sit where you can see my phone because I'm going to show you a little video, okay?
A parrot.
What is this that you're seeing?
A parrot.
It's a parrot. This is Captain Tony. Captain Tony is mine and Joe's pet parrot. And this is a video. Can you see this? Do you see Captain Tony, our bird? You see that, Bjorn? That's Captain Tony. Well, last night when he was going to sleep, I took a video. So watch Tony as he falls asleep. Do you see how his eyes are starting to close? He's getting tired. You know how you brush your teeth before you go to bed? Well, what Tony's doing with his beak is the same thing you do when you brush your teeth. He's cleaning it and making sure that his beak stays nice and strong. And his eyes are closing because he's so sleepy. And I call those his happy birdie noises because he kind of talks to himself a little bit as he goes to sleep. Well, Captain Tony is mostly what color?
Green.
Green. Well, we had a really scary thing happen one time. Our green bird got out of the house and flew across the street into our neighbor's yard in Anchorage and disappeared in a bunch of green birch trees. Well, how hard would it be to see a green bird in a bunch of green trees? It would be really hard, wouldn't it? So we went running out, calling his name, and we couldn't find him, and we couldn't see him, and all of our neighbors knew Captain Tony because he's nice and loud, and so all the neighbors came running out looking for him and calling his name, and he wouldn't answer, and we didn't know where he was, and we were getting scared, and I was crying, and then I remembered how much Captain Tony loves Joe. He loves Joe so much that he knows the sound of Joe's truck. And when Joe's truck comes driving down the street, Tony screams in delight. And so I said, Joe, go get in your truck and drive around the block. And sure enough, Joe drove around the block. And as he was coming back to our house, way up in the top of a tree, we heard a bird squawk. And we could tell which tree he was in, and we put a ladder against it, and Joe climbed up that tree and rescued his bird who doesn't know how to fly very well. Isn't that amazing that Tony could hear Joe's truck and know that his favorite person was coming to take care of him? He knew the sound of Joe coming home and knew the sound of his voice and knew that his person would keep him safe. Well, in our scripture today, we heard Jesus say, "My sheep know my voice and they follow me." And just like Tony knows and loves Joe and knows that he will take care of him, we can love and know Jesus and know that he will take care of us and guide us and protect us and teach us how to be kind and gentle and loving and merciful. And so let's pray together to Jesus. Let's bow our heads and close our eyes a second. Jesus, thank you for being our shepherd and help us to be like your sheep, following you and trusting your voice. And we all say, amen. Thank you all for being up here today. Will you please stand as you're able for our song of preparation, All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name. In your hymnal, it's on page 154, and we're going to sing verses 1, 4, and 6. Those are the verses that you'll see in your bulletin or on the screen in front of you if you are worshiping at home. You may be seated. Whose voice comforts you? In times of high stress or anxiety, in times when you're angry or upset, in times when you're sick or hurt, whose voice settles your spirit, calms you down, makes you feel safe? Since today is Mother's Day, many of you might call to mind the soothing voice of your mother or your grandmother or a beloved aunt or neighbor. I think about my mother-in-law. When I was growing up, it was a bad thing to get middle-named. Lisa Marie, get in here! If my parents middle-named me, I knew that I was in trouble. And that, of course, meant that I never really liked having my middle name used. But my mother-in-law is different. She uses middle names as a sign of affection. She loves to talk to her children, Patricia Ann, Joseph Carey, and Mary Lou. She always calls her grandchildren by their full names. When she calls us, she asks us, how is Jonathan David and Christina Michael doing? And she speaks wistfully about her granddaughter that passed away, Carrie Beth. So I knew I was truly part of the family when Barbara Jean started calling me Lisa Marie. It transformed the way I thought about my name, and it became a sign of love and affection. You might notice that on my email signature, I even have Lisa Marie Talbot, because I love that reclaiming of my name, said in a loving voice. Another soothing voice or group of voices are some dear friends that I meet up with regularly. Just hearing their voices and their laughter makes me feel at home. Makes me feel wanted and loved and cherished as a sister and a friend. When I'm stressed out or agitated and I hear their voices, I know that I am safe and surrounded by their loving presence. And of course, the voice I always long to hear is Joe's, especially if I'm sick or upset. I just want the refuge of my husband who will care for me and comfort me. I always tell Joe that the worst part of us getting in fights is when I'm mad. He's the one I want to talk to about it, and I can't if I'm angry with him. Jesus says that my sheep hear my voice. I know them, and they follow me. Somehow over these last few years, the term sheep started getting thrown around as an insult between different groups of people. Some say that people who vax and mask are sheep, and some people say that people who are anti-mask and anti-vax are sheep. And it's terribly ironic that even groups of Christians throw this name around as if it is an insult and not an honorific. We are sheep of Christ's flock. We are lambs of his fold. It means that we are a community. We are dependent on one another and on the one that we follow. Our shepherd guides us, guards us, protects us. Our shepherd leads us, and we are invited to follow him. The voice of our shepherd is our ultimate comfort. During the season of Eastertide, we are invited to consider the ways that we can live out the resurrection every day, the ways that we can be people of the abundant life, the fullness of life in Christ. And the good news is that we don't have to do it alone. We have one another, our beloved flock, to rely on, to walk together, to keep each other on the right path. And we have Christ our shepherd who calls to us. Let us listen to the voice of our shepherd, and like good sheep, let us follow him in the path of righteousness, justice, and mercy. Alleluia and amen. Will you stand for our song of response, Lamb of God? This is in the black hymnal on page 2113. The words are also in your bulletin and on the screen if you're worshiping from home. Today is Mother's Day, and so during our time of our prayers today, I want to lift up a Mother's Day prayer. I adapted this from a prayer written by Reverend Carrie Kreps Winaxix, especially for Mother's Day and all the different kinds of mothers. Let us pray. God of heaven, as a hen gathers her chicks, so you gather your children to you. God of Eve, We pray for all who have known pain in childbirth. God of Sarah, we pray for all who experience your impossible promises. God of Rebecca, we pray for all who trust you and journey into the unknown. God of Leah, we pray for all who feel unloved. God of Rachel, we pray for all who feel treasured. God of Miriam, we pray for all who dance in praise of you. God of Tamar, we pray for all who fight for justice. God of the daughter of Jephthah, we pray for all who suffer exploitation. God of Hannah, we pray for those who mourn their infertility. God of Jael, we pray for all who fight oppression. God of Esther, we pray for all who step up for such a time as this. God of Ruth, we pray for all who create their own new family. God of Bathsheba, we pray for all who have been assaulted and abused. God of Hosea's promiscuous wife, we pray for all whose stories we don't know. God of Mary, we pray for all who have lost children. God of the prophet Anna, we pray for those who are barren and yet rejoice in the children of others. God of Lydia, we pray for all who lead their households to know you. God of Tabitha, we pray for all who do good in your name. God of Mary Magdalene, we pray for all who are misunderstood and yet continue to search for your Son and proclaim the good news of his resurrection. As people who are all created in your divine image, we pray. Amen. This series, we have been exploring different versions of the Lord's Prayer to help us hear these ancient words in new ways. Today, our prayer is an adaptation from a prayer written for a Dominican sister's retreat. Let us pray this Lord's Prayer together. Our Father and Mother, who art in heaven and who are in all the earth, hallowed be thy name, and holy is your truth. Thy kingdom come, and along with your wisdom, thy will be done. May your circle be one uniting heaven and earth. Give us this day our daily bread, and give to us a nurturing spirit. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and heal through us as we ourselves are healed. Lead us not into temptation, but into the fullness of life. Deliver us from evil and liberate all that is good. For thine is the kingdom, the glory, the wisdom, the power, and the presence, now and forever. Amen. I am always overwhelmed by your generosity, and once again, I want to thank you. Last week, we celebrated Native American Ministry Sunday, and over $300 was donated to that special Sunday offering. 50% of that special offering stays here in Alaska for our own conference ministries with Alaska Native peoples and encouraging Alaska Native seminary students, and half of that goes to the denomination as a whole to encourage scholarships for Indigenous students across the country and across the world. We do a lot to give to others, but sometimes we do have to think about internal projects that need to be done as well. So I do have a couple of special projects that we're working on here around the church building that I want to invite you to consider. I mentioned that Savannah and I are working on a grant for some air filters for the sanctuary that we can move around the building to all the different places that people gather to keep them safe during this time. Oftentimes when you write a grant, the grant tour likes to see that you've ponied up some money too. And so we're looking for about a 10% donation to help us show the Homer Foundation that we too are working towards this. We think we are still working on final numbers, but we think it'll cost between $2,000 and $3,000. So we're looking to raise $200 to $300 to be 10% of that amount to show the foundation that we are doing our part to make this happen as well. So if you'd like to make a special donation towards the ventilation, please just write ventilation on your check or let us know to go towards that project. The other special project that we're working on is our long-awaited kitchen conversion to natural gas. We've been anticipating this for a few years and have not had the chance to do it yet, but if you've walked around downstairs, you've probably seen the ceiling panels down along where the pipes run. We got a very kind bid from a local contractor who always gives our church a really deep discount on their labor because of their gratitude for the work our church does for the community. And so the estimate for the project is $10,000. We have a little bit of that in the bank that we have saved over the years, but we are also looking for donations for the natural gas conversion for the kitchen. And so if you were interested in making a special donation for that, please just put kitchen on your check, or you can send us an email if you donate online. So that we can get those special projects going. And once we have the kitchen converted and can open up the downstairs again, we can move back towards fellowship time, which I know that we're all longing for. So we are always generous in giving to the world through UMCOR, giving to our community. And sometimes we need to give to ourselves so that we can complete the projects that we need to keep our building a safe and welcoming place for all people. Thank you all so much for your continued generosity. If you're worshiping online, you can make a donation through our website or send a check to the street address on the screen. You know, here in person, we have our donation box in the back, or of course, you can visit our website as well. Let us bow together as we offer ourselves and our gifts to God. Loving Shepherd, we thank you for your tender care. Everything we have comes from the goodness of your love. Receive the gifts we return to you now, that others may come to know you and discover you as their own loving shepherd. In your name we pray. Amen. Will you please stand as you're able for our closing song? It's in the red hymnal on page 88, or it is in your bulletin and on your screen if you're worshiping at home. May you go forth today, secure in the knowledge that you are a Lamb of God, a Lamb in Christ's flock, a sheep of the beloved Shepherd who is with you always. Go forth to follow Jesus. Amen.